Hey everybody, I've had a few questions on my backrest here, so I thought I'd give you the dimensions in case you want to build it or have a shop build it for you. This is black pipe, and it usually has threaded ends on it. You can get it any hardware store, Menards, Home Depot, any place like that. And I took an angle grinder to it, and I took, a very minimal amount off of it. Basically, I just took the coating off of it and shined it up. It is 15 and a half inches center to center. All this is mounted on an SW Motec rack, and the bike is a Kawasaki Versus 650. It's a 2010 model. The pipe that this slides into is seamless pipe, and it is near as makes no difference an inch exactly on the outside. Eighty-five-hundredths of an inch inside. The wall's the difference. Do the math. That gets welded onto a plate back here. Now how I did this was I took a piece of 3-inch steel and put holes in it the same as the bolts used to hold the luggage rack on. I tack welded this tube to the front corner here. And then I had this whole loop and slide bar assembly built. And then I did both of these, one on each side, and I slid this tube into it all the way back. I tack welded it again, so I had two places so it'd stay straight. I slid it forward, I tack welded it on the other side, and then slid it back and forth until it kind of reached a point where it was basically straight and level with this whole assembly here. Another tip is if you do this, leave these bolts loose. Put all four of them in, but leave them loose. And then have someone slide this backrest in and out while you slowly tighten these. And it will kind of self-align. Once I had this sliding in and out freely with the four tack welds in it, I went to the back, and this is just a piece of 1-inch steel cut at an angle on both sides, and then I welded that in between the pipe and the plate. Okay, on the back here, I've got a 1/4-inch nut welded on, which really, if you're doing this on a metric bike, try and use all metric parts. That's kind of a hindsight thing on my part, but I've got these 1/4-inch thumb screws I thought it'd be neat to use. Well, they don't stay in by themselves, that's why I've got the lock nut assembly there. And I've just got neoprene stoppers that I pounded into the end of the tube and cut off flush. I only had three, but you could get plastic caps like the rack has. That'd look really nice. Couple more dimensions on this. There's not very many that you actually need to build this. Obviously, if you have a shop do this, they might need to take your bike for a while. I would say to do it with the rack on the bike, because if you take that off the bike, I know on this rack and this bike, it does tweak a little bit when it's off the bike. There's drop cloths you can use to cover the bike so it doesn't get hurt, and you can actually weld on the bike. Again, this is 15 and a half center to center, this pipe. This is 1-inch steel here. The top of these two pipes is level with the top of the seat. The top of this arc is 4.5 inches. Now this is a Kawasaki Versus factory gel seat. It's 4.25 inches. This piece 4.25 above the gel seat. If I measure this in an arc, it's
18 and a quarter. What else do we need here? I just bought whatever pad off of eBay I thought would fit my back well. I mean, it's $15 pad. It's just wood foam wrapped in leather. This is 1.5 inches, and what I did was I hung it off the back a little bit, so you can see, and I welded in here, and it actually turned out flat. I couldn't believe that. But the reason I did that was this pipe nipple here. It wouldn't be very strong if you just welded that pipe nipple to this. It also wouldn't be very flat. So what I did with this piece, and there's also one on the bottom, is I tack welded it in the middle on both sides, or front and back, top and bottom. So it had a gap here and here, and then I just filled that gap in with weld. I got a pipe nipple that a 5/16 bolt would fit through, and I welded that on. I cut the threaded portions off, obviously. And what these brackets are, they are just angle iron, and I rounded the edges. I cut this angle in one of the sides of the angle iron, and I drilled two holes, and then I used my angle grinder to cut down to each side of the hole to make those slotted. What that allows you to do is have these brackets slide in and out depending on what you want to use for a spacer. What I've got is a 5/16 bolt that is 4 inches long, but this is actually a metric washer here because it's just barely bigger than the head of the bolt, instead of having a regular 5/16 washer, which is actually higher than the top of this bracket. Now, you could get machine washers if they have them where you pick up your hardware. But this is a grommet that you would use if you were passing a cable or wires through a metal hole so it didn't wear on it. Then I've got another washer. Now, washers are built by a machine stamping them out. So one side is smooth and curved, and the other side kind of has an edge to it. I put the smooth side this way towards the grommet so it doesn't eat into the grommet, and it'll just eat on this metal. And then I've got the same thing on the other side with a Nylock nut. And when this hinges, I don't know if you can tell in the video, but the washer on the inside is wearing on this piece instead of wear on the rubber. And basically what that rubber is doing is allowing this to stay in place. Now, yeah, it'd stay in place if you didn't use the rubber, but it wouldn't stay in place very long because you'd have metal parts pressed together and it'd wear a lot faster. With this rubber, as the metal wears, it expands because I have it compressed a little bit, and then it stays adjusted longer. Again, just neoprene stoppers pounded into the end of here and cut off flush. That's basically all you need to know to build one of these.